This is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have a cool gardening show for you. Basically, I've been so busy just doing other things in my life, haven't been able to make as many garden updates and episodes as I'd like, but you know, I'm still here gardening, doing all kinds of projects. I just haven't had time to film them all because I've been so busy with just planning the health expo that I'm going to be putting on here just in about 30 days. And also I gave a talk actually last night at Cafe Gratitude in Healdsburg, California. It was an amazing talk. Had a bunch of people show up, and it was really cool. But I'm sorry, and I apologize. I couldn't actually film my own talk to put up for you guys. The event coordinators that actually coordinate and plan and do that event actually would not allow me to film my talk. They filmed it, so they're gonna put it up on their website, and you know, probably charge you money to see it or something if you want. So I apologize about that. But what I did do for that talk, actually, I made a resource list. And this is the growingyourgreens.com Sonoma County Vegetable Gardening Resource List that I've compiled. And these are all my favorite places where I buy all my things to grow food here in Sonoma County. So I'm just going to basically go over this list, since I can't easily mail this or put it out. I'm just going to go over this list for everybody. So these are my valuable resources for Sonoma County to, number one, save money. Number two, get the highest quality, you know, seeds and starts to be successful. So like many people ask, where do you get the rock dust, John? Where do you get the compost? Where do you get your seeds? Where do you get your starting plants? Well, here's the list, and we're gonna go over that right now. So the soil. So the soil is the foundation of your garden. Definitely, if you don't live in Sonoma County and have access to the Sonoma compost, which is basically they take our green bins, all the people's yard waste and food scraps, they take those and compost it on an industrial scale, and I have other videos of that so you can see what it looks like. And they sell it back to us, so they take free stuff, right? From us, our waste, they process it and then sell it back at like $20 approximately per yard. Man, they're making some good money, but they're doing a great job. And more importantly, it's OMRI certified, so it's certified OMRI, which means Organic Material Review Institute. So that means it can be used in organic production, which is what I want to do, organic production. I don't want to use any, you know, chemicals and other things in my garden, so that's good. I buy the Mallard Plus certified compost, and a 15% off coupon is usually available if you go to the Sonoma County home shows or other places where they have booths. So I usually, when I see the coupons, I'll take a couple extra ones for you know, my next couple purchases. And best to buy it by the cubic yard, although they will sell it by the bag. You know, I think it's around $2 for the bag, and the cubic yard price depends on the kind you get. I recommend the Mallard Plus, or you could also get the Featherlight Amended Soil, which is basically a Mallard plus a organic certified soil that they blend together. So that actually might be better than just straight compost, but that's also more expensive. And you can't apply the coupon to the Featherlight. Besides growing in compost, the other thing that I would really encourage everybody to grow in is rock dust. And rock dust can be very hard to find. Luckily here in Sonoma County, we have an excellent resource. It's called Lee Ballister's. Lee Ballister's is at 1250 Sebastopol Road, Santa Rosa, California, 95407, 707-526-6733. Their hours are Monday through Friday from 8:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. And they sell basically the glacial rock dust. At this time, it's approximately $15 to $16 for 50-pound bag. That's the best place and lowest cost place in Sonoma County to buy rock dust right now. Recommend them. They also have the Azomite, which is another brand of rock dust. And that's about $21 for 44-pound bag. And the question I get, John, well, hey, what rock dust should I get, glacial rock dust or azomite? Well, you know what? I pretend to buy more the glacial rock dust because it's less expensive, but every couple loads, I'll get some azomite to mix it in, because every kind of rock basically has different minerals, so you get a different spectrum. So my friend Don Weaver, who's the remineralization expert, he says, you know, use them all. And then the other question could come up is, hey, John, what about ocean-grown fertilizer? Or ocean grown or ocean water? Well, there's a company down in Florida, Ocean Grown, and I have some of their minerals too, and it comes in a 1 gallon jug. It's concentrated minerals. You basically dilute that with water and then feed it to your plants. It's a lot easier to ship than 50 pounds of rock dust. That's another excellent way to remineralize the soil, is through ocean water. So actually I use all three different sources. And I've also tried other sources for rock dust, like your local rock quarry. You could get rock dust at your local rock quarry. You want to ask for basically you want to ask them for rock dust, but they might not know what that means. So you want to ask them for the smallest particle size, like the dust that comes off when they sort it. I think it's like, I forget the actual technical term. they call it. But many rock quarries may sell rock dust, but not all rock dust at quarries are the same grade or quality. Some may not be so good, but the benefit is it's going to be really inexpensive in most cases. I mean, you get a truckload full for, I don't know, 20 bucks, and that's a lot of stuff. But one time I did buy it here, and it was a lot of gravel. So there was some dust, but lots of gravel. So maybe not as good as buying the real stuff, the azomite or Gaia Green glacial rock dust. Plant starts are excellent because they give you a jump on your garden to start get growing now, and you don't have to wait for the seeds to sprout. Also, they'll probably offer you a greater level of success. Sometimes if you germinate seeds and you plant seeds, sometimes they don't come up good. Sometimes they come up stringy and leggy. Sometimes you forget the water, you lose them. But if you start with plant starts, you just buy the starts, pop in the ground, and you're off and growing. So they're really fun. They're really good. The three places in Sonoma County that I highly recommend are, number one is Skyview Nursery. I did have an episode on Skyview. They sell at various farmers markets, most likely the Santa Rosa Vets Building Farmers Market, Wednesdays and Saturdays, 8:30 a.m. to noon. And that's Glenn over there. And if you look for my videos on the Santa Rosa Farmers Market, you'll see where I basically have a shot there at the Skyview Nursery booth, and he's selling all his starts. And if you buy in a large quantity, he might give you a better deal. So just, you know, talk to him about that. Sink Farms, 1369 Kaiser Avenue, Santa Rosa, California, 95404, 707-585-8811. So it's Sink Farms. That's where I got all these strawberries right there in the bed next to me. And got about 100 strawberry plants there. Great, they've been doing great. Those are the same strawberries that they actually grow at their U-Pick farm. So you could go to Sink Farm and do U-Pick strawberries, which is gonna open pretty soon. But also, the value of Sink Farm is they sell plant starts at a really affordable price. Anywhere from $1 to $1.50 for their plant starts for one plant in a nice big container. And they're healthy plants, let me tell you. I got like all my cilantro there recently. I got all my cocky pumpkins there. Let's see, a lot of my tomatoes actually were from Sank. You could see I did a video when I visited Sank and bought my tomatoes and strawberries. Let's see, Imwali Gardens, did a video on Imwali. Imwali's at 685 3rd Street, Santa Rosa, California, 95401, 707-546-0279. And I purchased many of my cucumber, summer, and winter squash and peppers there. You could buy them in basically a whole flat, so fill up a whole half flat, and they'll give you like a couple bucks off. So that's a better way to do it. And the trick is there, they have little 4-inch pots, and in each 4-inch pot, usually there'll be like one plant, but some things they overseed, so sometimes they'll put up to 6 plants in one little 4-inch pot, sometimes 7. I've got up to 9 before. That's rare, though. So you could get 6 plants in one 4-inch pot, and then it costs you $1.19. So basically, that's like if you take the pot, and then you basically carefully get it when it's young. If they're getting too old, it's harder to do. You could basically subdivide and divide all the plants out, and then thereby made each plant basically cost you 20 cents. So at some level, it's almost cheaper in some case to let other people do the work, get the starts, and then you plant them. You have a higher success rate and a lot less, you know, problems. But one of the negatives is that you'll have less varieties to select from. So like at Imwali, for example, they sell about 4 varieties of cucumbers: lemon cucumbers, Market More 76, pickling cucumbers, and Armenian cucumbers. So, you know, if you want to grow other varieties, you're out of luck. So that's why I recommend seed starting and buying seeds, you know, for some of the things. So I start a lot of things from starts, but some of the things I start myself. So for seeds in Sonoma County, the couple places I recommend, number one is a Baker Creek Seed Bank, and that's at 199 Petaluma Boulevard North, Petaluma, California, 95452, 707-509-5171. And they are open Sunday through Friday, 9:30 to 5:30. And remember, they're closed Saturday. And you could also order online, rareseeds.com. I did do an episode early in the spring talking about seed catalogs and seed companies, and Baker Creek was on there. Just at least go to their website and sign up for their seed catalog to get one mailed to you. That just makes an amazing, like, coffee table book because it's just full color, nice large pictures. Man, it gets people excited about gardening when you're seeing all these cool, unusual fruits and vegetables you've never seen before. So I'm lucky to have them and have a store here in Sonoma County. So I often go down there to buy and support them. And, you know, there's over 1,400 varieties of seeds. So there's nowhere else in the county that has that many seeds available. So if you live in Sonoma County, we're very lucky to visit Baker Creek. And actually, at my talk yesterday, I asked how many people have been to Baker Creek. And maybe like 2 people out of 30 or 40 people raised their hand. So we need to get the Baker Creek people and buy some seeds, support them, support what they're doing, and get those seeds, those more rare varieties, out to people and get them growing and get people saving their seeds. Very important. The last place actually is up in Willits. It's a Bountiful Gardens. I haven't actually been there yet, but I have ordered mail order from them, and I like because they have also a wide selection of rare seeds and unusual seeds. They're at bountifulgardens.org is their website. So I only have ordered online. I want to get up there to do a farm tour. They have farm tours on rare occasions, and I'll make an episode as soon as I get up there. It's supposed to be really cool. And you can see I got a couple projects going on. I got these big thing, these big redwood posts in the background. And what I'm building back there is basically a huge 8-foot by 8-foot redwood stake trellis that I'm building from scratch out of just redwood stakes. And I'm growing that for my khaki pumpkins. You know, most trellises are 4x4, and I want to build a nice custom, well-designed and well-looking trellis. So look for that in an upcoming episode. So this is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. Keep on growing, and we'll see you next time.